Hello and welcome to the Attaching to Process video. This will demonstrate AQTime's Attach to Process feature, which lets you profile applications that were not started by AQTime. Usually, when you're profiling applications with AQTime, you create a profiling project and then start profiling by pressing this Run button right here. This will run the application in debug mode under AQTime. That is, the AQTime is going to act as a debugger for the application and then can then trace function calls in it, detect allocations and releases of memory blocks, and perform other actions. Though almost all applications can be started under AQTime, doing this can be a non-trivial task in some specific situations. Imagine, for instance, that you're testing your application for some time and notice that at a particular point, the application starts consuming too much memory. If you close the application, load it in AQTime, and attempt to reproduce the problem, you're going to have to spend time waiting for the problem to happen again, and it's quite possible that you'll fail to reproduce the specific conditions that caused the problem. So the solution is to try analyzing the current situation in the application by attaching AQTime to it. And you do that with this attach process command that you see right here. The attach process feature lets you profile applications that were not started by AQTime. That is, you can start your app outside of AQTime and then attach the profiler to it on the fly and profile your code. The attach to process feature is the best way to trace errors that are hard to reproduce. Once you notice the application behaving oddly, you can attach to it and figure out what's going on. A typical example of an application that can be profiled with the attach to process command is a service or some application that is launched by the operating system. Let's see how you can do that with AQTime. Now, note that AQTime Pro includes special service profiling mode for profiling Windows services. However, in this demonstration, we're not going to use that mode, and we're going to profile the sample service with the attach to process feature. And in my demonstration, I'm going to use this sample service that you see right here highlighted inside my control panel, and this just checks some system metrics. This service was started by the operating system. You can see right here it was started automatically. So I'm going to attach to this running service with the attach to process command and then profile the service with AQTime. Profiling with the attach to process feature doesn't differ much from ordinary profiling. I've already created a new project here, and now I'm going to add my executable module to my project. So I'm just going to go over here to the setup panel. I'm going to right click, say add module, and then I'll browse out to where my application lives. Okay, now in order for AQTime to be able to profile modules with the attach to process feature, those modules must meet the same requirements as during a normal profiling run. That is, they must be compiled with debug info. So for instance, if you're going to profile an executable, make sure it contains debug info. If you're going to profile a DLL that's loaded to some process, then that DLL must also be compiled with debug info. The process's executable may have no debug information, but the DLL itself would need that debug info. Alright, so I've selected the service module, I've clicked open, and AQTime has created a profiling project for my service. Now, with that project created, we need to configure it. So what we're going to do here is make sure that the normal mode is selected from the drop-down list, and that's because the attach to process feature only works when normal profiling mode is active. I'm going to select the profiler that will be used to analyze the service. In this case today, we're going to go with the allocation profiler. So what we're going to do is track memory usage in our application. Okay, so now we're ready to start profiling. So to do that, I'll select Run, Attach to Process from the main menu here. And AQTime invokes this Select Process to Attach to dialog. This dialog displays a list of all the processes that exist in the operating system at this point in time. Now, by default, system processes are hidden, and because our service is running under the system account, it's also hidden. So to make it visible, I'm going to check this Show System Processes box. Okay, so now all I need to do is locate my service in the list. There it is. I've got it highlighted, and now I'll click OK. And now AQTime attaches to the process, and in order to do this, it's going to inject its special DLL into the process address space and start instrumenting the profiled module. All calls to functions that occurred before instrumentation will not be profiled and will not be included in the profiling results. Now, AQTime generates profiling results automatically when the profiled application closes. As our service does not stop until the computer shuts down, AQTime won't be able to generate profiling results automatically. In this case, to get our results, we need to click the Get Results button up here on the toolbar, which looks like this little camera right here. So I'm going to click that. There we go. And now we can see in the results we have a class right here, whose live count is 7. That means that 7 memory blocks were allocated during the profiling run and were not destroyed by the time we generated results. So to check whether these instances are released during the service run, I'm going to gather results once again. So I'm going to press get results again here. And I see now that there are 13 live blocks in memory. So it looks like this service is constantly creating new instances, but not deleting them. So let's stop the profiling process and view the profiling results in detail. So to stop the profiler run, I'm going to click this terminate button right here. And note that that command will also stop the service. So I'm just going to click that. To see the objects that were not destroyed at the moment of result generation, I'm going to double click on the objects category right here. And the report panel on the right displays the list of unreleased instances. And the get number column that you see over here on the right side of the screen specifies the number of get results commands that generated the current results. So here we can see these 5 instances were created when we first clicked get results, and the remaining instances were created when we clicked get results the second time. And note that none of these instances were released when we closed the service down. So we do have a memory leak here. So let's see how these instances were created. I'm going to select any one of these instances here in the report panel and switch over to the details pane down here. And here we can see the list of functions that led up to the creation of the selected instance. The topmost function in the call stack is this malloc debug function that allocates a memory block from the heap. This function is called by the available RAM function in our application right here. So let's have a look at the source code of the available RAM function. So I'm just going to double click on this guy, and that brings up the source code for that function, and AQTime has placed the cursor on the line of code that calls the malloc debug function. As we can see from the available RAM function's code, this function gets the amount of free virtual memory on the local computer. The information about the system's current usage of memory is retrieved with the global memory status function, which you see right here on line 154, and that function stores information in a memory status structure. The available RAM function dynamically allocates memory for this structure, but as you see, it doesn't free it after using it, and thus we have a memory leak. So you may ask why we have 13 instances of C++ native memory class. Well, if we switch back to the details panel, we'll see that the available RAM function is also called by the check system metrics function. Let's take a look at that function's source code. And here we can see that this method, check system metrics, is called by the service execution thread, which you see right here. And what we have here is a situation where a method is being called over and over again every 5 seconds. So every 5 seconds when the service is running, a block of dynamic memory is being allocated. Over that time, while we were profiling a service, it allocated 13 blocks of dynamic memory and didn't release them. So in fact, there's no need to allocate memory for the memory status structure dynamically. So what I'm going to do is change the available RAM's function code so that it allocates memory for the memory status structure statically. Okay, I've already opened the service sample solution here inside of Studio, and now I'm going to change the available RAM function so that it allocates memory for the memory status structure statically. So here we go. I'm going to make some tweaks really quick here. Okay, I fast-forwarded a bit, just made a few tweaks to the code, and now I'm going to save my changes and rebuild my application. Now I'm going to profile the service with AQTime again to see whether our memory leaks were fixed. But before we do that, we need to restart our service. So I'm just going to right-click on this guy and say start. And we'll restart the service. And now we can come back into AQTime and we'll reattach to that process. So I'll select run, attach to process. Again, we'll select our sample service from the list of services that are available. And now AQTime is profiling our service. So I'm going to wait about 10 to 15 seconds just to make sure that the service has a chance to call the available RAM function. Okay, to fast forward a bit through that pause, okay, we had about 15 seconds. Now we're going to generate some profiling results by clicking that Get Results button. And as you can see, the report panel here is empty. That means the service is no longer producing memory leaks, so we have successfully fixed the problem. So you've seen how easy it is for AQTime to attach to a process and profile it on the fly. This saves you time because you don't need to restart your application under AQTime in order to reproduce a bug. You can just connect to the already running application and analyze the current situation. Now note that the Attach to Process feature is only supported in AQTime Pro. AQTime Standard does not provide this functionality. And if you have any questions or if you'd like additional information, please visit us at our website, smartbear.com. Thanks for watching and have a great day.